Hi everyone, today's topic is angles and their measurement. Definition of angle: the figure formed by two rays with the same initial point is called an angle. Here we are having a figure formed by two rays with the same initial point. Initial point means starting point. These two rays are starting from the same point, so this figure is called an angle. The common initial point is known as the vertex of the angle. This common point is called the vertex of the angle, and the rays forming the angle are called its arms or sides, and the rays which are forming this angle are called its arms or sides. The standard unit of measuring an angle is degree. As we measure distance in kilometers, liquids in liters, we can also measure angles. The standard unit which we will measure angles is called degree, and the symbol for degree is this. The small circle we'll use to represent degrees. The common point where the two rays meet is called the vertex, and the rays that make up the angle are called the arms, and the measure of the size of the angle is called degree. Depending on the measure of the angles, angles are classified into different kinds. If the measure of the angle is exactly 90 degrees, it is called a right angle. If the measure of the angle is less than 90 degrees, it is called an acute angle. If the measure of the angle is more than 90 degrees and less than 180 degrees, it is called an obtuse angle. And if the measure of the angle is exactly equal to 180 degrees, it is called straight angle. If the measure of the angle is more than 180 degrees, it is called a reflex angle. And if the measure of the angle is exactly equal to 360 degrees, it is called full rotation or complete angle. The right angle will be in L shape. Acute angle will be in the shape of less than symbol. Obtuse angle will be like this. Straight angle will be in the shape of a straight line. Here a semicircle is formed in the middle. Reflex angle will be in this shape. And full rotation, complete angle, will be in the shape of a circle. Naming angles. One way is to use the angle symbol followed by three letters. Here this symbol is used to represent angles followed by three letters. The first and the third letters indicates points on the two arms. Here the first and the third letters indicates points on the two arms. The letter in the middle is the vertex. The letter in the middle should be the vertex. We can name this angle as angle A, B, C, or else angle C, B, A. Here, order of the first and third letters may change, but the middle letter should be the vertex. Next, second method, using the angle symbol only with the vertex point. Instead of using these three points, we can just only use the vertex point and we can name the angles. The angle would be called angle B. By using the angle symbol followed by the letter or the number between the angle. Instead of using letters, we can represent with numbers also. This would be angle 1. Here we are having 6 cases. Out of 6 cases, 4 are correct and 2 are wrong. Let us see. Angle A, B, C. Because vertex point is in the middle and the remaining points are in the first and third positions, these 2 are correct. And the vertex point represented with angle symbol, so this is also correct. Here we represented the angle with number, this is also correct. But here the vertex point B is in the third position, so this is wrong. And here also the vertex point B is in the first position, so this is also wrong. Measuring angles. To measure the angles, we use a tool named protractor. This is the protractor. The tool which we use to measure the angles is called protractor. This is the protractor, and this one is called the center point of the protractor. This line is called the 0 degrees baseline of the protractor. This line is called the 0 degrees baseline of the protractor. This point is called the center of the protractor. And protractor we are having from left to right here, top scale 0 to 180 degrees. In the same way, from right to left also, bottom scale. See here, bottom scale 0 to 180 degrees. Two scales are there on the protractor. From left to right, 0 to 180 degrees. And from right to left, 0 to 180 degrees. This top scale is called the outer scale. and the bottom scale is called the inner scale. Now we'll see how to measure angles. Place the center of the protractor on the vertex B. Place the center of the protractor on the vertex B. See here, we have placed the center of the protractor on the vertex B. Adjust the 0 degrees baseline of the protractor so that it lines up with line BC. Adjust the 0 degrees baseline. This is the 0 degrees baseline. We have to adjust it such that it coincides with the ray BC. See here, the 0 degrees baseline of the protractor and the ray BC both are coincide. Place the center of the protractor on the vertex B. Place the center of the protractor on the vertex B. Adjust the 0 degrees baseline of the protractor so that it lines up with line BC. Here, 0 degrees baseline is lined up with line BC. Since the angle is acute and the 0 degrees line or baseline was used from the right, you will take the reading from the inner scale. See here, always we start measuring from 0 degrees. Here, 0 degrees is in the inner scale. Here, the ray is going towards right. When the ray is going towards right, the 0 degrees baseline is in the inner scale. So, we'll take the inner scale to measure the angle here. So, here the angle formed is 0, 10, 20, 30 degrees. Here, the measure of the angle is 30 degrees. Here, we can see we are measuring, the ray is going towards the right side. So, 0 is in the inner scale. So, we'll measure by taking the inner scale. Here, 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70. So, the measure of this angle is 70 degrees. In the same way, here, the ray is going towards right side and 0 degrees is in the inner scale. So, we'll take the inner scale to measure the angle. 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90 and so on, 130. So, the measure of this angle is 130 degrees. Here we can see that we are measuring from left side. The ray is going towards left side and we are measuring from left side. Here always we start measuring from 0. So 0 is on the outer scale. So we'll use outer scale to measure here. 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100, 110, 120 and 121. The small we'll measure for as 1 degree. So 121 degrees, 122, 123, 124 and 125. So the measure of this angle is 125 degrees. In this example, here also we are measuring towards left side. So we'll take the outer scale. Why? Because 0 is on the outer scale. So 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 41, 42, 43, 44 and 45. So here the measure of the angle is 45 degrees. So if the ray is going towards right side, we'll take the inner scale, and if the ray is going towards left side, we'll take the outer scale to measure the angles. And here, what is the measure of the angle? Here the ray is going towards right side, so we have to take the inner scale. So the measure of the angle here is 20 degrees. Here also we are measuring towards right side, so we'll take the inner scale. So the measure of the angle here is 155 degrees. What is the measure of the angle? Here we are measuring towards the left side. The ray is going towards left side. We are measuring towards the left side. So we'll take the outer scale to measure. So the measure of this angle is 140, 141, 142, 143, 144 and 145 degrees. Here in this example also we are measuring towards left side. So we have to take the outer scale. Why? Because 0 is on the outer scale. So the measure of this angle is 120 degrees. Angles in our daily life. See here, walking stick. Here angle is formed here. If the angle is properly set here by the carpenter, then only it will give grip to the old persons to hold the stick. So here angle is used. And on the roads we will see this type of lines. So straight lines, these are 180 degrees. Angles are used here. Next, hangers, angle is used here. You can see an obtuse angle is formed here. Next, scale, measuring scale, laptops. We'll open our laptops like this. This is in the shape of L, so it is right angle. All of you like pizzas, and pizzas will be like this. Here an angle is formed. Scissors also angle is formed here. Next ice cream cone, here angle is formed here. Next boomerang, angle is formed here. And here hanger, here also straight line, straight angle is formed here. Angles in our daily life. So the points, the things which we have to remember in this chapter are: the figure formed by two rays with the same initial point is called an angle. Next, the common initial point is called the vertex, and the two rays are called the arms of the angle. Next, the standard unit of measuring an angle is degree. Kinds of angle. Depending on the measure of the angle, we are classified angles into different kinds. If the measure of the angle is 0 degrees, it is called a zero angle. If the measure of the angle is exactly 90 degrees, it is called a right angle. If the measure of the angle is exactly 180 degrees, we call it as a straight angle. If the measure of the angle is exactly 360 degrees, we call it as a complete angle. If the measure of the angle lies between 0 degrees and 90 degrees, we call it as an acute angle. If the measure of the angle lies between 90 degrees and 180 degrees, we call it as an obtuse angle. If the measure of the angle lies between 180 degrees and 360 degrees, we call it as a reflex angle. Thank you.